and welcome to Behind the Science, where we ask challenging questions directly to the scientists who are trying to solve today's toughest problems. I'm your host, Jennifer Fournier. Get ready for another epic Behind the Science battle episode. This time, SPE sorbents compete for the title of the best phase for highly complex samples. This is no easy task. One must take into account many variables. But in the end, the deciding factors really need to be robustness, minimal variability, and low, if not zero, matrix effects, because that is what makes data interpretation very complicated. So before this battle gets even more out of control, let's go back to the lab and challenge these SPE sorbents. They won't see what's coming. Ladies and gentlemen, today we are in the SPE wet lab where we have another battle brewing between which SPE sorbent is up for the battle of removing the most matrix effects from a complex sample. In this corner, we have Shin.
Hi, Jen. In this case, we have 22 compounds to separate. Some of them are isobaric, same mass, you know, means mass spectrum cannot identify it alone. Besides, in this case, the whole blood is the matrix, and it is a very complicated matrix. If the cleanup is not effective, the matrix effect is going to be very, very high. But I have my confidence in the Oasis Prime HLB. I'm going to put my money in there.
All right, good luck, Shin.
Sure.
And in this corner, we have Scott.
Hey, Jen, I'm so excited for this battle. I got a chance to redeem myself after losing that Hillock chromatography one. I was so excited to see that Shin had a SPE battle going, and I think with three different products, I'm gonna be able to take this competition, so I'm putting all of my money on those.
All right, good luck, Scott. So to keep everything fair, we're going to process the samples under the same conditions, okay?
Sounds good.
All right, let's get ready to clean up. Let's take a closer look at what they're doing.
Let's take a closer look at the competing methods. We kept the sample pretreatment the same for all of the sorbents. Now, Scott must use the traditional five-step method that includes the conditioning and equilibration steps, since his sorbents aren't water wettable like Oasis Prime HLB. The remaining steps are the same, where we wash with 25% methanol and then elute with a solution of 90%, acetonitrile, 10% methanol. We then evaporate and reconstitute the samples in 30% acetonitrile.
And the results are in. Scott, let's get your data with your three sorbents.
Here you go.
Oh, thank you, and it's sweaty. Okay, and Shin with Oasis Prime.
Here you go.
Let's go analyze this data.
First, we're going to take a look at the recovery and reproducibility of all the sorbents. The first thing you'll notice is, again, we looked at 22 synthetic cannabinoids in this example in whole blood. Oasis Prime is in blue, and the other sorbents that Scott used are in the red, green, and the purple. You can see from the average results that Oasis Prime HLB generated the highest, most consistent recoveries for the panel. You'll also see that in the chart, the ranges were quantified and the percent recovery standard deviation range for the competitors' products were much higher, with higher RSDs as well. The Oasis Prime HLB recovery range was much more consistent with an average of 3 to 7%. The next thing we needed to look at was the matrix effects and cleanliness of the sample eluents. You can see in the bottom three chromatograms that the three sorbents that Scott used had a lot of ion suppression, and that's due to the fact that a phospholipid co-eluted with our compound of interest, JWH203. With Oasis Prime HLB, we had very minimal matrix effects, only 11%, and that's due to the fact that Oasis Prime HLB removed the phospholipid.
Wow, the data was obvious. The winner of the battle for the SPE sorbent that removed the most matrix effects is Shin and Oasis Prime. Congratulations, Shin.
Thank you, and I know it.
Until next time. Wow, These battle episodes are so stressful. The pressure Scott had to not try out those sorbents, I don't blame him for getting so frustrated. These scientists were up for the challenge, though, and did a great job with a really tough sample. I was amazed by the results. Who would have thought a simpler method would be the more robust and effective? If I had to choose, Oasis Prime HLB will be my first choice each time. Check out the links below to learn more about different applications using Oasis Prime HLB. And join us next time as we go behind the science to make SPE methods less painful.